How the team will be continuity of a function of several variables. Continuity of a function of several variables. We introduce an continuity. Continuity of a function of several variables. We introduce an important auxiliary concept that of the neighborhood of a given point. The neighborhood of radius R of a point M zero of X zero, Y zero is the collection of all points with coordinate X and Y that satisfy the inequality square root of x minus x zero squared plus y minus y zero squared is less than r. That is the set of all points that lie inside a circle of radius r with center in the point m0 with coordinate x0 and y0. If we say that a function f of x, y possesses some property near the point with coordinate x, 0, y, 0, or in the neighborhood of the point x, 0, y, 0, we mean that there is a circle with center at x, 0, and y, 0, at all points of which circle the given function possesses the given property. Before considering the concept of continuity of a function of several variables, let us examine the notion of the limit of a function of several variables. There be a function that is f of x, y, defined in some domain G of an xy line. Let us consider some definite point m0 in G or on its boundary. It is y-axis, x-axis, and any domain G. For example, this end point M0 with coordinate X0 on the x-axis and Y0 on the y-axis. Why is it? Yeah, plot the circle of radius R with center in the point M0 circle. I try plot it. It will be neighborhood. This circle with radius R. With distance R, radius. Definition 1. The number A is called the limit of the function f of x, y S M of X, Y approaches M0 with coordinate X0, Y0 if for every epsilon is greater than 0, there is an R is greater than 0, such that for all points M with coordinate X and Y, for which the inequality M, M0 vector is less than R, is fulfilled we have the inequality modulus of f of x, y minus a is less than epsilon. Means m with coordinate x and y. If a is limit of f of x, y as m of x, y approaches m0 of x0, y0, then we write limit as x approaches x0, y approaches y0 of f of x, y equals a. Definition second. Let the point m0 with the coordinate x0 and y0 belong to the domain of definition of the function f of x0, xy. To the domain of definition of the function f of x0, xy, sorry. The function z is f of xy is called continuous at the point m0 with the coordinate x0 and y0 if we have
the function z is fx and y is called continuous.
Continuous, it's true.
Continuous.
Continuous. If we have limit as delta x approaches 0 and delta y approaches 0 too. Not. Maybe we write down some way x approaches x0 in the first and y approaches y zero. F of x y equals f of x zero y zero. So that equality 1 and m of x y, m with coordinate x y, sorry, approaches m 0 with coordinate x 0 y 0. In arbitrary fashion, all the while remaining in the domain of the function. Design it x is x zero plus delta x, y is y zero plus delta y, then 1 may be rewritten as follows. Limit as delta x approaches 0, delta y approaches 0, f of x 0 plus delta x, y 0 plus delta y equals f of x 0 y 0. 1 prime, or limit as delta x and delta y approaches 0, if of x 0 plus delta x y 0 plus delta y minus f of x 0 y 0 equals 0, 1 to prime. We said delta rho equals square root of delta x squared plus delta y squared. As delta x approaches 0 and delta y approaches 0, delta rho approaches 0 too. And conversely, if delta rho approaches 0, then delta x and delta y approaches 0 too. Noting further that the expression in the square brackets in y prime is the total increment of the function delta z. Y2 prime may be rewritten in the form. Limit as delta rho approaches 0 of delta z equals 0. Because if delta x approaches 0 and delta y approaches 0, delta rho approaches 0 too. And delta z equals this distance. Difference. A function continuous of each point of some domain is continuous in the domain. If at some point n with coordinate x0 and y0 condition 1 is not fulfilled. Then the point N with the coordinate x0 and y0 is called a point of discontinuity of the function that is f of x, y. For example, condition y prime may not be fulfilled in the following cases. The first, z is f of xy is defined at all points of a certain neighborhood of the point n with the coordinate x0, y0 with the exception of the point n with the coordinate x0, y0 itself. The second, the function that z is f of xy is defined at all points of a neighborhood of the point n with the coordinate x0, y0 but there is no limit as x and y approaches x zero and y zero consequently. Of the function f of xy. The third, the function is defined at all points of the neighborhood of n with coordinate x0, y0, and the limit exists But this limit don't equal to f of x zero y zero. Example 1. The function that that is x squared plus y squared is continuous for all values of x and y. That is, it is continuous at every point in the x-y plane. Indeed, no matter what the number x and y, delta x and delta y, we have delta z equals x plus delta x squared plus y plus delta y squared minus x squared plus y squared. Or 2x delta x plus 2y delta y plus delta x squared plus delta y squared. Consequently, limit as delta x and delta y approaches zero, both of these, delta z equals zero. The following is an example of a discontinuous function. Example 2. The function z is 2xy over x squared plus y squared is defined everywhere except at the point x is 0 and y is 0. we call denominator 0. Now we have 5 minute rest and then we continue. Our next topic, partial derivatives of a function of several variables. Definition. The partial derivative with respect to x with respect to x of a function z is f of xy of a function z is f of xy is the limit of the ratio of the partial increment delta z with respect to x with respect to x. To the increment delta x as delta x approaches 0. The partial derivative with respect to x of the function z is f of xy is denoted by y on the symbols. Z prime with respect to x, f prime with the lower index x of xy, dz over dx round z. It's important, not strict round, and df over dx. Thus, by definition, dz over dx equals limit as delta x approaches 0 of delta with the lower index x z over delta x, or limit as delta x approaches 0 f of x plus delta x y minus f of x y over delta x. Similarly, the partial derivative with respect to y of a function z is f of xy is defined as the limit of the ratio of the partial increment of the function delta z with respect to y Now the increment of delta y as delta y approaches 0. The partial derivative with respect to y is denoted by y on the following symbol as z prime with respect to y, f prime with respect to y, round dz over dy, or round df over dy. Thus, dz over dy equals limit as delta y approaches 0, delta y z over delta y equals limit as delta y approaches 0, f of x y plus delta y minus f of x y over delta y. Noting that delta z with respect to x is calculated with y held constant, and delta z with respect to y with x held constant, we can formulate the definition of partial derivative as follows. The partial derivative of the function z is f of xy with respect to x is the derivative with respect to x calculated on the assumption that y is constant. The partial derivative of the function z is f of x, y. With respect to y, is the derivative with respect to y calculated on the assumption that x is constant? It is clear from this definition that the rules for computing partial derivatives coincide with the rules given for functions of one variable. And the only thing to remember is with respect to which variable the derivative is sought. Consider the example. Example 1. Given the function z is x squared times sine of y, find the partial derivative dz over dx and dz over dy. Solution. Dz over dx equals sine of y is constant because y is constant. Sine of constant is constant because we consider this function as constant and take out this sign of our derivative. and we have derivative of x squared is 2x and sine y just constant. Then dz over dy. In this case, x squared is constant. And we take x squared out derivative and calculate derivative just of sine of y. And we have x squared times derivative of sine of y with respect to y, or x squared times cosine of y. It is partial derivative with respect to x and with respect to y. Example 2. Take the function z is x to the power of y and find dz with respect to x and derivative with respect to y. Solution. Dz over dx it means x is variable, y is constant, is y is y times x to the power
y x power y minus 1.
Yes. Dz over dy. In this case, x is constant and we calculate a to the power y. Constant to the power y is x to the power y times natural logarithm of x. The partial derivative of a function of any number of variable are determined similarly. Thus, if we have a function u of four variable x, y, z, t. What is it? Example. Oh, not example. We have the function of four variable. U is f of x, y, z, t. Then du over dx equals limit as delta x approaches zero ratio in the numerator f of x plus delta x y z t minus f of x y z t over delta x. Du over dx, dy equals limit as delta y approaches zero f of x y plus delta y z t minus f of x y z t over delta y, etc. Consider the example. Example 3. Let us the function is
you said that we will take a 10-minute break. We will not?
Now we ended this example and 10-minute we will have. Yes?
Okay.
One example, it's not very long. X squared plus y squared plus x t z cubed, maybe. Du over dx. Look, y, t, z, all of these constants. And calculate only x. X squared to x. Y squared constant 0. T this cubed. Take out. X is 1. It's we have t z cubed. Then du over dy. X constant 0. Y squared to y. And this 0. And du over dt. Dt. 0, 0, x, 0, x, z cubed. And du over dz. 0, 0, x, t times 3, z squared. 3, x, t, z squared. Understand? Is it clear? Next, subtitle, the geometric interpretation of the partial derivatives of a function of two variables. The geometric interpretation of the partial derivatives of a function of two variables. Let the equation z is f of xy be the equation of a surface shown in next figure. plot, maybe z axis. Y-axis, x-axis. And our figure. Draw the plane X as is constant. Any, for example, here x. Parallel with y axis. It's parallel x-axis, this may be point N, good. And this parallel z-axis. Vertical line point C. This and good. The intersection of this plane with the surface length, the length PC. Maybe the point P. Is point B. This and this line fits in. Mm-hmm. Good. Let's see. For a given x, let us consider a certain point M with the coordinate x, y in the x, y plane. This point M, coordinate X, and Y, this coordinate Y. To the point M, there corresponds a point P with coordinate X, Y, and Z. One minute, please. What we stop to the point M, there corresponds a point P with coordinate X, Y, Z on the surface Z is F of X, Y, holding X constant. Let us increase the variable y by delta y. Maybe write down this. delta y equals mn equals p t prime. Parallel y-axis c prime. Then the function z will be increased by delta z equals t prime. This t prime to be point n with coordinate x and y plus delta y. There corresponds a point t with coordinate x, y plus delta y, and z plus delta z with respect to y. The ratio delta z y over delta y is equal to the tangent of the angle formed by the second line PT, this line, with the positive y direction. Delta z y over delta y is tangent t e t prime. This angle, maybe here, but point B, same angle, beta. Consequently, the limit delta y approaches zero, delta z y over delta y equals dz over dy is equal to the tangent of the angle beta followed by the tangent line PB to the curve PT at point P. With the positive y direction. Dz over dy equals tangent, tangent beta. Thus, the partial derivative dz over dy is numerically equal to the tangent of the angle of inclination of the tangent line to the curve resulting from the surface z is f of xy being cut by the plane x is constant. Similarly, the partial derivative dz over dx is numerically equal to the tangent of the angle of inclination alpha of the tangent line to the surface z is f of xy cut by the plane y is constant. If we consider this on our plane, it will be maybe this, this, and this. Or not. Angle alpha. In the point A. Subtitle, total increment, and total differential. Maybe. The next subtitle, total increment, and total differential. By the definition of the total increment of the function z is f of xy, we have delta z equals f of x plus delta x y plus delta y minus f of xy. Formula 1. Let us suppose that f of xy has continuous partial derivative at the point with coordinate x and y under consideration. Express delta z in terms of partial derivatives. To do this, add to and subtract from the right side of expression 1, f of x, y plus delta y. Delta z equals f of x plus delta x, y plus delta y, minus f of x, y plus delta y. Plus f of x, y plus delta y, minus f of x, y. Formula 2. The expression f of x, y plus delta y, minus f of x, y, in the second square bracket may be regarded as a difference between two values of the function of the variable y alone, the values of x remaining constant, applying to this difference the Lagrange theorem, we get f of x y plus delta y minus f of x y equals delta y times d f of x y with the upper line over dy, formula 3, where y with the upper line lines between y and y plus delta y. In exactly the same way, the expression in the first square bracket of expression 2 may be regarded as the difference between two values of the function of the variable x alone. The second argument retains the same value y plus delta y. Applying the Lagrange theorem to this difference, we have f of x plus delta x y plus delta y minus f of x y plus delta y equals delta x times derivative of function f of x with the upper line y plus delta y with respect to x formula form, where x lies between x and x plus delta x. Introducing expression 3 and 4 into 2, we get delta z equals delta x times df of x with the upper line y plus delta y over the x plus delta y times df of x y with the upper line over dy. Formula 5. Since it is a sum that the partial derivatives are continuous, limit as delta x approaches 0 and delta y approaches 0 of df of x with the upper line y plus delta y over dx is df of x y over dx, and limit as delta x and delta y approaches 0, df of x y over dy, y with the upper line, equals df of x y over dy. Formulas 6. Because x, x with the upper line and y with the upper line respectively lie between x and x plus delta x and y plus delta y, x with the upper line and y with the upper line approach x and y respectively as delta x and delta y approaches 0. Equalities 6 may be rewritten in the form df of x with the upper line y plus delta y over dx equals df of x y over dx plus amma first and df of x y with the upper line over dy equals df of x y over dy plus gamma second formula 6 prime, where the quantities gamma first and gamma second approaches 0 as delta x and delta y approaches 0. That is, as delta rho equals root of delta x squared plus delta y squared approaches 0. By virtue of 6 prime, relation 5 becomes delta z equals df of x y over dx times delta x plus df of x y over dy times delta y plus gamma first times delta x plus gamma second times delta y. Formula 5 prime. The sum of the two later terms of the right side is an infinitesimal of higher order relative to delta rho is square root of delta x squared plus delta y squared. Indeed, the ratio gamma first times delta x over delta rho approaches 0 as delta rho approaches 0. Since gamma first is an infinitesimal and delta x over delta rho is bounded, delta x over delta rho modulus of this is less than or equal to 1. In similar fashion, it is verified that gamma second times delta y over delta rho approaches 0. The sum of the first two terms is a linear expression in delta x and delta y. For x, f of with respect to x, f prime with respect to f of x, y not equal 0, and f prime with respect to y of x, y not equal 0. This expression is the principal part of the increment. Differentiating from delta z by an infinitesimal or of higher order relative to rho write down definition. The function z is f of x, y, the total increment delta z of which at the given point with coordinate x and y may be represented as a sum of two terms, a linear expression of x and delta y, and an infinitesimal of higher order relative to delta rho is called differentiable at the given point. While the linear part of the increment is known as the total differential and is denoted by dz or dx. From 5 prime, it follows that if the function f of xy has continuous partial derivative of a given point, it is differentiable at this point and has a total differential dz equals f prime with respect to x of xy delta x plus f prime with respect to y of xy delta y. Equality 5 prime may be rewritten in the form delta z equals dz plus gamma first delta x plus gamma second delta y. And to within infinitesimals of higher order relative to delta rho, we may write the following approximate equality. Delta z approximate equal to the dz. We shall call the increment of the independent variable delta x and delta y differentials of the independent variable x and y, and we shall denote them by the dx and dy respectively. Then the expression on the total differential will assume the form dz equals df over dx times dx plus df over dy times dy. Thus, if the function z is f of xy has a continuous partial derivatives, it is differentiable at the point with coordinate x and y, and its total differential is equal to the sum of the products of the partial derivatives by the differentials of the corresponding independent variables. Consider the example. Example 1. Find the total differential and the total increment of the function z is x, y at the point with coordinate 2 and 3. 4. Delta x is 0.1 and delta y is 0.2. Solution. Delta z equals x plus delta x times y plus delta y minus xy. Or y delta x plus x delta y plus delta x delta y. Xy, this and this, valid. Dz equals dz over dx times dx plus dz over dy times dy. Or y dx plus x dy, or y delta x plus x delta y. Consequently, delta z will be equal 3 times 0.1 plus 2 times 0.2 plus 0.1 times 0.2 is 0.72. dz is 3.0.1 plus 2.0.2 or 0.7. The foregoing reason and definition are appropriately generalized to function of any number of argument. If we have a function of any number of variable w equals f of x, y, z, u, or not y, u, etc. t, and all partial derivatives df over dx, df over dy, etc. to df over dt are continuous at the point x, y, z, u, etc. The expression dv equals df over dx times dx plus df over dy times dy plus df over dz times dz plus etc. plus df over dt times dt is the principal part of the total increment of the function and is called the total differential. Proof of the fact that the difference delta w minus dw is infinitesimal of higher order there than square root of delta x squared plus delta y squared plus delta z squared plus etc. plus delta t squared is conducted in exactly the same way as for a function of two variables. Example second. Find the total differential of the function u is e to the power to the power x squared plus y squared times sine squared of z of three variable x, y, z. Solution. Noting that the partial derivative du over dx is e to the power of x squared plus y squared times 2x times sine squared of z, du over dy is e to the power x squared plus y squared plus dy times sine squared of z, du over dz equals e to the power of x squared plus y squared times 2 sine of z cosine of z or using the secondary school formulas e to the power x squared plus y squared times sine of 2z. A continuous for all values of x, y, z, we found that du equals du over dx times dx plus du over dy times dy plus du over dz times dz equals e to the power of x squared plus y squared times the bracket in the bracket 2x times sine squared of z dx plus 2y times sine squared of z dy and plus sine of 2z dz. Our next subtitle, Approximation by Total Differential. Approximation by Total Differentials. Let the function z is f of xy be differentiable at the point with the coordinate x and y. Find the total increment of this function. Delta z equals f of x plus delta x y plus delta y minus f of xy. Whence f of x plus delta x y plus delta y equals f of xy plus delta z. Formula 1. We had the approximate formula delta z approximately equal to dz. Formula 2. Where dz equals df over dx times delta x plus df over dy times delta y. Formula 3. Substituting into formula 1, the expanded expression for dz in place of delta z, we get the approximate formula f of x plus delta x y plus delta y approximately equal to f of xy plus df of xy over dx times delta x plus df of xy over dy times delta y. Formula 4. To within infinitesimal of higher order relative to delta x and delta y. We shall now show how formula 2 and 4 are used for approximate calculation. Example. Problem. Calculate the volume of material needed to make a cylindrical glass of the following dimensions. Radius of interior cylinder R. Altitude for of interior cylinder H. Thickness of wall and bottom of glass K. This K, this K. This R, this H. Letter A, exact solution. The desired volume V is equal to the difference between the volume of the exterior cylinder and interior cylinder. Since the radius of the exterior cylinder is equal to R plus K and the altitude is H plus K, V is P, pi, sorry, times R plus K squared times H plus K minus pi R squared H. Or V is pi times 2RHK plus R squared K plus HK squared plus 2RK squared and plus K cubed. Formula 5. B. Approximate solution. Let us denote by F the volume of the interior cylinder, that F is pi R squared H. This is a function of two variables R and H. If we increase R and H by K, then the function F will increase by delta F. But this will be the result for volume V. V is delta F. On the basis of relation 1, we have the approximate quality V approximately equal dF. Or V approximately equal dF over dR times delta R plus dF over dH times delta H. But since dF over dR equals 2 pi RH, dF over dH equals pi R squared, delta R equals delta H equals K, we get V approximately equal to pi times 2RHK plus R squared K. Comparing the result of 5 and 6, we see that they differ by the quantity pi times h k squared plus 2r k squared plus k cubed, which consists of terms of second and third order of smallness relative to k. Let us apply these formulas to the numerical example. Let R is 4, H is 20, and K is 0.1. Applying 5, we get exactly V is 17.881 pi. Applying formula 6, we have approximately V approximately equal to 76 pi. Hence, the approximate formula 6 gives an answer with an error less than 0.3 pi, which is 100 times 0.3 pi over 17.881 pi percent, which is less than 2% of the measured quantity. I think in this moment we can stop.